And then something to kind of end out here. These labels of liberal and conservative will change over time. And so we have some pictures and some social issues to consider, and you know you can apply these to the political, the economic realm. So think about this. When the Beatles first hit the States in 1964, a lot of parents were freaking out. Were these exceptionally liberal young artists coming over from England influencing their children? I mean, look at them. Long hair, singing about love and about boys and girls and all this. And a lot of parents in the 60s were like, whoa, this is so new. It's totally out there. That's very liberal. But now we hear the Beatles as Muzak at Safeway. Nobody thinks twice about hearing Love Me Do or Yellow Submarine. Because by today's standards, the Beatles are not so liberal. They're almost to the extent where their music is kind of conservative because it's old-fashioned, because it's traditional. Similarly with Elvis. When Elvis hit the scene in the 50s, people were freaking out about him, saying, oh my goodness, he's so liberal, he's so out there. They wouldn't even show him on TV from the waist down, because TV producers felt like his dancing was over-sexualized and so provocative, that it was so new, that it was changing the face of music and was going to corrupt society because he was so liberal and so new. Again, you hear him in the elevators. Hound Dog, while at the time was this like progressive, liberal piece of rock and roll, today is played on the Golden Oldies station. Doesn't seem to get anybody into a tiff. And so these terms can certainly change over time. What was once liberal can now be more moderate or even moving into the traditional conservative realm. Look at Liberace, pretty flamboyant piano player from the 1970s. Was he on the edge with his outfits and costumes then? Yeah, some people reacted and said, maybe that's a little bit too much. But we look at this now and say, yes, that's a pretty big, gaudy, beaded costume thing. But we've seen worse now. So even though he was deemed as liberal back in the day, Liberace does not seem to be making humongous impacts in our society today. Another example in the piano realm, Elton John. You look back at some of his earlier albums back in the 70s and 80s, he's kind of out there in terms of his costuming, the way he performed, the way he dressed, and that's how people saw it. He is this liberal, progressive artist who's kind of pushing the limits. But now Elton John is writing more conservative pieces overall. He wrote the Lion King musical. He wrote music for the funeral of Princess Diana. At one point, yes, he might have been cutting edge and liberal and out there and pushing for change through his artistry and his music. But now he's become a little bit more mainstream, even a little bit more conservative. I don't know too many teenagers who say, oh yeah, I'm listening to Elton John on my iPod. Because it's kind of old-fashioned. Again, what once was liberal is now a little bit more traditional. And so just kind of going along the idea of artists and how they change, when Madonna hit the circuit in the mid-80s and she had an album called Like a Virgin, people were freaking out, like, oh my goodness, over-sexualized. How can they talk about music like this in such an open way and put it on MTV where every kid can see it? Well, again, that album, Like a Virgin, now plays on the Golden Oldies station. Things have changed. So when Madonna is on the VMAs and she's making out with Britney Spears on stage, at the time, even in the 90s, this was kind of liberal. Like, wow, this is, oh, I can't believe this is going on. We're seeing this on network TV. This is a big deal. This has totally changed. This is pushing the limits of what's appropriate and what's not. But we look at this now, 10 years, 15 years later, and we say, you know what? We've seen worse. And so again, what was very liberal at the time might be more mainstream, might even be more conservative by today's standards. Look at the rap world. When Run DMC came out in the 80s, people were freaking out again, saying, oh man, influx of rap music into mainstream culture. These guys are gonna change the world. They're gonna change how kids talk and think and feel and believe. By today's standards, Run DMC is pretty tame. The latest artist that kind of filled in that gap for a while was Eminem. Oh, we don't want our kids listening to this guy. He's changing how they think, feel, and believe. And even now, Eminem, not as rough around the edges as he used to be. people in the 90s, early 2000s freaking out about what he was saying and doing. Now, kind of a blip on the radar. Again, what was very liberal then has changed its fitting into society now. What was new? So we saw two women kissing on stage. Adam Lambert, I think at the VMAs or the Grammys, kissed a guy. And again, ruffled a bunch of feathers when that happened a couple years ago. But now, watch what's on TV, watch what's on the networks. You're seeing Modern Family that has gay dads raising children. Watch Scandal on ABC. They have a pair of gay men on them also. So when Adam Lambert did that back a couple years ago, it seemed very liberal, progressive, and out there. But now you can look on almost any network during primetime hours and see gay couples kissing. Times have changed. And Lady Gaga, what can you say about her? I mean, when she came out there in crazy headdress like this or her meat suit, yes, at the time it seemed very liberal, progressive, changing, pushing the boundaries. Now, she's kind of toned it down. She doesn't have the shock factor that she once did. And so again, the point is, things that were very liberal at one time have become a little bit more conservative now. And granted, we're talking in this section about social issues, how music or artists or performers have changed from very liberal to very moderate to even potentially conservative. But we can look at this and also go into some of the political and economic realms too and say, wow, back in the day that was a very edgy issue. But now we accept it as kind of commonplace, more moderate, even conservative. So terms can certainly change with time. Not all of them will. Some things will continue to be exceptionally conservative, and some will continue to be exceptionally liberal over time. But please know that some things can change.